I'm Yutaro. Today, I would like to introduce what is the meaning of 留学. In this presentation, 留学 means a short period of studying abroad. First, I did 留学 when I was a high school student. I went to Vancouver for 3 months to study English. And at that time, I met a lot of people who came from all over the world, and I was surprised with multiculturalism. This means there are many, many cultures into one society. And how about Japan? Actually, Japan will become a multicultural society. For example, in 2020, Tokyo Olympic Games will be held, and the government expects that there are 40 million Southern people will come to Japan. It's very, very huge. Like that, in the future, Japan will become a multicultural and international society. So we have to survive this kind of circumstances, but we don't know how and why. And I think the experience of 留学 will help me a lot. So in this presentation, I would like to explain why we should 留学. This is outline. First, multicultural society. The good example of immigrants. Immigrants, look at this photo. They are foreign families, and they want to come to Japan to live. So they called immigrants. And immigrants will introduce and did their own cultures into Japan. It is different from us. And so each person have different opinion to introducing different cultures. I don't like it or I like it. It's okay, but first we have to communicate with foreign people. And there are two barriers for communication. The first one is language barrier. These people use English and these people use Japanese, so there are language barriers between them. But some Japanese company try to remove it by using English, like Rakuten, Asahi, or Takeda Pharmaceutical Company. Or if we want to improve our English skills, just we can go to cram school like Kokojuku and so on. So we can break the language barrier in Japan. So this barrier is not so huge for us. The second one is the cultural barrier. He is Donald Trump, and Trump discriminated minority like Muslim or Mexicans into his election. And because of that, the hate crimes towards them has been increased. So the situation was very, very terrible. And there is the same situation in Japan. It is hate speech. And hate speech means very aggressive remarks and actions toward minority, especially Korean people. And the people who participated hate speech or hate crimes, they don't try to understand the cultural differences. They just say, I don't like Muslim or I don't like Korean people. So the cultural barrier is very huge and very big for us. And it makes a lot of problems all over the world. So how we can remove it? I think the experience of 留学 gives them ideas. I interviewed Tae. With my friend, I met her in Vancouver, and I introduced her story. So she became friends with Abdullah, who's Muslim, in Vancouver. But before 留学, Tae was afraid Muslim because in her image, Muslim was associated IS, and so she was afraid. But in her language school, she met Abdullah, and he's very, very kind, and he helped a lot to help her. and see rather that we are the same human beings. It doesn't matter who is Muslim or not. So she can break cultural bias by Liu Gangpu. So in conclusion, we can to break cultural bias, we should have Liu Gangpu. In fact, we can break the language barrier in Japan, but if we want to break cultural barrier, we should have Liu Gangpu. And Liu Gangpu expresses gives me an idea. And if we can break this kind of barriers, we can survive our multicultural and international society. And this is the meaning of Liu Gangpu. This is my conclusion. I rehearse that like this. So thank you for listening.
Thank you, Mr. Yamamoto. Do you have any questions or comments?
Thank you for nice presentation. Which country do you encourage me to留学?
Thank you. I think it depends on what you want to learn or what you are interested in. So it depends on the interest or what you like. So sorry, I can't say which is better or not.
Thank you.
Engineers.
So even though you want to understand the others, sometimes unexpected thing happens a lot because of the cultural differences or differences in law or something like that. So sometimes something that discourages you happens in the world. So what do you think? So what attitude do you have to have when you have when you go abroad? So what kind of do you have any opinions?
Thank you. In my opinion, the attitude is, I think, the most important thing is to accept different opinions and different way of think and different cultures. So if we can accept different cultures, we can understand a little bit, yeah. But it's very important for us to communicate with other people. Yeah, this is my opinion.
Thank you very much.
Okay, anything else? Okay, thank you, Ms. Yamamoto. Please give him a big hand.